such displeasure and disappointment. Nothing works, even though every calculation is precise. Now an interruption. How infuriating. Wait, wait. Divine energy. I'll have you know I participated in Lord Sothesil's 9 analyses of the Exalted Enigmas. But we have more important matters. I'm about to determine the correlation between a reciprocal exchange. Interesting, yes. I can see the benefits of such an arrangement. Very well. Just activate the crystals in the proper sequence while I modulate the energy flow. Less chance of an explosion that way. Again. A good start. Again. Not in the proper sequence. Try again. A good start. Again. Light. The reaction I was hoping for. A good start. Again. Such are the benefits of an extra set of appendages. The energy flows freely and without disruption, allowing the rods and the pistons to align in a most pleasing manner. Thank you. Now, why do you want to know about divine energy? Scent. How intriguing. I was just thinking about my former master, Sophus Seal, and the experiments we conducted. He desperately sought to understand the power he and his companions attained, especially whether or not that power was temporary. Not while I assisted him. He had a tool that he used to drain away minute bits of his own divine energy to store and study. He could extract it and return it as he saw fit. Not sure what became of the tool, but here are my notes from those days. More questions? Well, Lord Sophus Seal attributed curiosity to intellectual superiority. Suppose I should do the same. Ask, and I will attempt to tighten the cogs of your ongoing education as best I can. Odd question. Is a hammer a weapon? A saw? A Dwemer spring spanner? No, it was just a tool. A device crafted by Sophus Seal to aid in his endless experiments. Suppose I could imagine ways to modify the device. Haven't a clue. Tools have a way of wandering off when you don't stay vigilant. Had a guava used to swallow tools when I wasn't looking. Glowed for a month until the enchantment dissipated and the tool passed. Must have heard the screams. I was his apprentice, but that was years ago. Spent time working in the Clockwork City. That's what I learned about energy transference, Dwemer engineering, mechanical... The Arch-Colonel, Lord Vivek's high priest. Suddenly the gears aligned. I can think of a number of reasons that Alm and V would want to know about C and his tools. But some doors just... He's the father of mysteries, and the architect of time. One of the Tribunal. The three living gods of the Dark Elves. Creates all sorts of helpful and intriguing devices, like the Clockwork City. I haven't seen that. It's a wonder and a miracle. All brass tunnels, glass domes, and giant gears. He was inspired by the work of the Dwemer. The Clockwork City is pure Sophus Seal. He made it to forge the future and reshape the world. I love you.
I never understood how one could go so long.
You don't have a home calls to you.
Did you feel that just now? Did you come here for crafting certification?
At fair prices.
Ah, it's my comrade in arms. Welcome back to the hall.
Do you seek trade?
Ah, it's my comrade in arms. Welcome back.
Time passes.
You here for crafting certification? Don't worry, there's no cost involved. Your alliance covers all my fees. Once you're certified, they'll let you fulfill their daily requests for crafted goods, but they're only available to certified crafters. If you can show me, I can train and certify blacksmiths, clothiers, and woodworkers. If that sounds like something you'd want, we can get started. Of course. What do you want to know? Cloth and leather goods. The crafting writs want pieces of light cloth armor or medium leather armor, so that's what I certify. Anything with metal in it, and I don't mean horseshoes and calibers. The crafting writs are for weapons and heavy armor, so that's what I teach. Bows, shields, and magical staves. Staffs? No, it's staves. I always forget how to say that. Have you spoken with Danel Teleno? He handles certification and training for provisioning, enchanting, and alchemy. He's a bit stuffy, but he knows what he's doing. Excellent! We can get started whenever you're ready. Let me know if you have some time. I can train and certify you in something else. If you convince me you know how to use a needle and thread, I'll certify you. However, you must commit. I can't certify two things at once. Show me you can craft a pair of homespun gloves. First, you'll collect some raw jute, then return here and refine it. Finally, you'll use refined jute to make the gloves. Of course. It was the first trade I studied. I'm happy to certify anyone familiar with a clothing station. Now run for... Take the raw jute to a clothing station. If you have enough, you can easily refine it. Bring the refined jute to me when you're done, and then you'll make some homespun gloves. Raw jute is plentiful if you know where to look. Just don't chew on it. It can really do a number on your... Well, just don't chew on it. Take the raw jute to a clothing station. If you have enough, you can easily refine it. Bring the refined jute to me when you're done, and then you'll make some homespun gloves. If you're in a guild, check the guild stores. They often have raw materials and refined goods for sale. Of course.
I've been reading a most fascinating...
At times, I wonder if I should have remained a chef rather than joined the Mage's Guild. Perhaps I'd have served the Emperor. Served. A jest, you see? But...
Welcome.
Jode, Kuoko, Jejota. Jode, Deni, Ta.
Stuff here. Thank you.
Anything I can do for you? Before you make the gloves, you need to bring raw jute to a clothing station and refine it.
Could use a break.
Step up, have a look.
sword, I mean the knight by the word. By the word, I mean the end.
We have many customs, I suppose, will seem odd to you.
I don't deal in stolen goods, despite... I'd rather deal...
I can buy you.
What can I do for you?
little. Before you make the...
Ah, it's my comrade in arms. Welcome back to the hall.
Care to bargain?
Don't you just...
A time.
May I help you?
Before you make the gloves, you need... When I'm refining jute, I sing to help pass the time. Not too loud. I don't want to disturb the other clothiers. Head to the clothing station and craft a pair of homespun gloves. You shouldn't need much refined jute. Don't forget the style material. You can purchase them from any clothier or scavenge them yourself. Craft a pair of home... You know, I'm a master clothier, yet I still own a pair of homespun gloves. They keep my hands warm at night. Wonderful! Now for deconstruction. There's much to learn from breaking down your own work, even more so with someone else's creation. Head to a clothing station and deconstruct your gloves. Or anything else, really. Just be sure you do it there.
This is a life, isn't it?
So she next to
an adventure.
You're more than capable. Already done. You'll now be able to fulfill Clothier crafting writs, and I look forward to seeing more of your work. Let me know if you have some time. I can train and certify you in something else. Prove you know your way around a forge and I'll certify you. But I want you to craft a simple iron dagger. First you'll mine some iron ore, then refine the ore into iron ingots. Yes, you have to prove you know your way. There's a place outside of town which should still have some...
Thank you.
back. Refining ore into... Bring the iron ore to a blacksmithing station. If you have enough, you can refine them into iron ingots. Really put your back into it.
Yes. Hello. What are you doing out in the middle of no? Nervous? Me? Ha! Do not make this one laugh. Hollins here is just horrible. You will help? Oh, bless you. This one planted his... You are a true hero, Walker. A brave and no... Hmm? Sorry, I was just... Hey! You and I have the same... I am sorry. This one is a nervous wreck. Hollingir is growing a rare Khajiiti herb. Very delicate and very desired. Do not worry, Walker. You can depend on Hollingir. Fallura is this one's loyal farmhand. She is not very bright, and she is very lazy. Always scribbling. I could, but this one likes Fallura. Plus, she probably... She knows too much about... my farming practices. Yes. Hollingir has many secret farming tricks. Hmm? Sorry. I am sorry. This one.
So you've agreed to help Hollingir destroy his crop? I'm not sure whether to be heartbroken or elated. Just be safe, all right? This...
Well, we wouldn't want that, would we?
What? No, don't be absurd. Just do as Hellinger asked.
Thank you.
moment, please. You made it. Good. We have a great deal to talk about in a clearing to the southeast, but that can wait. I trust you've seen what Hallangeer and I were growing in there. Moon sugar. In its raw form. It's a crude narcotic, but if you refine it, it becomes something truly odious. I had to be sure he could do it. Moon sugar is temperamental. No one's been able to grow it here in Vardenfell until Hallangeer. I need you to take the notes you found to Captain Bethys in Seda Neen. It's complicated. I was a member of House Redwyn's Narcotics Oath Bureau. I made some very serious mistakes. If I brought this tip to Captain Bethys, he would ignore me. But he has no reason to distrust you. Please, do this for me, Sam. I'd rather not discuss it. Suffice it to say that the Skooma trade offers many dark incentives. Especially for undercover officers. It's easy to cross the line. Too easy. Hopefully this arrest and seizure will help me. If you'd ever taken it, you'd know. Skooma is a powerful hallucinogen. Addictive, deadly, and cheap. Lethal overdoses are routine in Morrowind. Once it's got its hooks in you, you'll do anything. I don't know. But it doesn't matter. He's developed a method to grow vast quantities of moon sugar in Vardenfell. That's a dangerous skill. Too dangerous. Can you imagine? Hallangeer's no Daedric Prince, but his work could be just as destructive. Please, just do the right thing.
You are kind to check up on Hallingir, but this one is fine. Again, thank you. What? How could she? Why would she do that? Hallingir is no threat to him? Skooma? No, no, no. Hallingir does not make Skooma. My sister and cousin were both addicts. This one would never make such a thing. I only grow moon sugar, Walker. For prey, Hallingir has huge appetites. A little sugar in the morning to start the day, a little in the evening to soothe the soul. Moon sugar is a beautiful thing, my friend. The Riddlefar's gift to all Khajiit. Is the pursuit of pleasure really so bad? Hallingir is glad you agree. This one just needs to gather his belongings, then he will be on his way.
Hallingir? I thought him a clueless sugar sop. If he's managed to grow moon sugar here in Vardenfell, he's more cunning than he seems. Make no mistake, we'll find him. The Tribunal thanks you for your help, Outlander. Take this as your reward. Did you need something else? A Skooma Baron you'd like to report, perhaps? No? Then move along. Falura, that Skooma fiend can barely put her trousers on straight, let alone conduct an investigation like this. You must be mistaken. Difficult to say. If I had my way, she'd be hanging from the nearest tree. I'll pass it on to my contacts in the Oath Bureau. I will be honest, though. Her chances are very...